The industries that shape our society don't reflect the people who live in it.
We're talking specifically about the legal field, which handles the laws that define our lives, and the STEM field, which produces the technology we use every day.
In Good Trouble, Callie and my character Mariana find themselves working in both of these fields. But in real life, women and people of color in these professions are extremely rare.
How rare? Well, first, let's talk tech. Technology is theoretically made for everyone, but it's not made by everyone.
For example, women make up more than half the population, but less than a quarter of STEM employees. And for the women who do make it into STEM careers, half of them report facing gender-based discrimination, an even higher percentage than those in non-STEM fields. And for Mariana, who is both a woman and a minority, it can be even worse. Like when Alex, Mariana's boss, straight up tells her that putting up with racist and sexist jokes is all a part of the job.
Mariana, could you respond to the group chat about the Digital Planet account?
Oh, yeah, sorry, doing that now.
Jeez.
Very funny, Alex.
Wow, Mariana, I don't think I have to tell you, this is very inappropriate workplace behavior.
You know, I could take this to HR.
Oh, so could I. This could be considered sexual harassment.
All of this results in technology that doesn't always meet the needs of women and minorities.
Well, the consequences of the tech world's overwhelming white bro culture is evident in facial recognition technology. Now, experts tell us these tools were largely developed by white engineers who were working from code developed to recognize white faces.
As a result, FBI researchers have found facial recognition technology is more likely to make mistakes on the faces of black people.
And if you think that's bad, the effects of underrepresentation can be even more severe in the legal world, where the representation is just as skewed.
Women make up just 21% of partners at private law firms and 33% of US district court judges. And according to the American Bar Association, 88% of lawyers are white. So let's talk about how that affects outcomes. Prosecutors give better plea deals to white defendants.
Black defendants are more likely than white defendants to be charged as repeat offenders, even if they have similar records.
And white federal judges are 4 times more likely than judges of color to dismiss cases of race discrimination. That bias extends beyond the courtroom, too. One study that looked at how racial biases affect bankruptcy decisions was pretty unsettling.
In the study, bankruptcy attorneys were asked to give financial advice to 2 hypothetical couples who were going broke.
The results found that the lawyers were more likely to recommend a more punitive type of bankruptcy to Reggie and Letitia than they were to Todd and Allison.
So we need more diversity in these fields because it can make our courts more just and create technology that meets the needs of our diverse society.
So how do we get it? In both the STEM and legal fields, we need to reject the idea that women and people of color are somehow less competent than white males.
The reality is these groups have the talent, but our higher learning institutions also need to do their part.
We also need to open up the career pipeline for minority students. College is already unaffordable for most low-income families, but even when minority students do enter 4-year programs, too many drop out because they aren't getting the support that they need.
By making higher education both more affordable and welcoming to minority groups, everyone can reap the benefits.
More diversity, especially in STEM and law, means a better world. Share this video to fight for more diversity in the workplace.